RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'm going to talk about the differences between accuracy and precision, two different ways that we measure how good our results are. And so just some definitions, and I'll do a bunch of examples. Accuracy is how close a measured value is to the actual value, and precision is how close the measured values are to each other. All right, don't think about that too hard. Let's just do the examples and then I'll go back to the definitions. So I'm going to be doing an example using a dartboard, which I think is one of the best and easiest ways to understand the two differences between these two concepts. You may have seen it before, and sometimes people just learn what the best analogy is and then you just roll with that. So I definitely think this one is worth learning. So over here in our little gray box, we're going to look at the actual value. So we know if we're trying to throw something at a dartboard, we're looking to get a bullseye, right? This is the goal. So now we're gonna say that we have four different darts. And in these four tries, we're going to do the best that we can. So our first example is going to be low accuracy and low precision. So for low accuracy, that means that our actual tries are not close at all to the center. So maybe our four darts would end up like this. All right, this was very, very inaccurate. We didn't get anything close to the bullseye. And this is also a very low precision guess because remember, the precision is how close the measured values are to each other. So not only were these darts not accurate, they also weren't close to each other. They also weren't precise. All right, so now we're going to do our second throw of the dartboard, and this is going to be low accuracy, but high precision. So it's going to not be accurate. We're not going to get the center of the dartboard, but it's going to be precise. They are going to be close to each other. So something that would look like that is maybe a guess like this. So this was super precise. All the darts got about in the same place. Very, very precise. All of the values are close to each other, but it's low accuracy, right? They're not close to what we wanted, which was the center of the board. So now next, let's do high accuracy, low precision. So in this case, we're going to get close to the center, but we're not going to be very precise. So that'd be something like this. All right, so yeah, the darts are pretty accurate. You would look at this and say, that's pretty good. But they weren't really that close to each other. So they weren't very precise, they had low precision. And now let's see the best case scenario of all these throws, which is high accuracy and high precision. So we're going to get in the middle of the dartboard and they're also going to be really close to each other. So that'd be like this. Very accurate, very precise. Okay, so that's kind of an analogy that's easy to understand visually, I think, and kind of helps us start to get this concept. But in chemistry or science, we're not going to be really throwing dartboards. So let's actually learn something that these concepts would be tested towards. And in a lot of cases, it's going to be weighing something or getting the mass of something. All right, so now let's say we're going to weigh a random cube of silver, let's say. And let's say that we actually know the exact value of it, or your teacher does, or somehow we just know that this value is exactly 5.00 grams. So now let's go through the four different scenarios that we could get. All right, so first, and for this example, let's say that it's your job to measure this cube four different times in lab and report your results. So let's say our first example is, again, low accuracy and low precision. So we weigh the cube four different times, and here is what we get. All right, so we got 6.32 grams, 3.01 grams, 7.55 grams, and 4.02 grams. So none of these were that close to 5 grams, and they also weren't close to each other. So they were very low accuracy and they were very low precision. If this is what you got when you weighed this cube five times, you should really get your scale fixed or throw it away or check your technique, right? Something is very wrong if these are your results. So now let's do the next one, which is low accuracy. So it's still not gonna be close to 5 grams, but it's high precision. All right, so we got 8.32 grams, 8.35 grams, 8.29 grams, and 8.32 grams. So in this situation, we are super precise. It's just like the darts. They're all very close to each other, but it's not accurate at all. It's not correct. So in this situation, you probably have something specifically wrong with your scale, or you keep on adding something else to it that you don't realize, right? So in this case, the scale may be able to get fixed. Maybe it just adds about 3.3 grams to anything you weigh, but whatever you want to do, you also wouldn't want to use this scale, right? And now let's do a high accuracy but low precision measuring four times. So we're going to be getting close to the actual value, but it's not going to be super precise. The values are going to be a little bit all over the place. So maybe that looks like something like this. So we had 5.15 grams, 4.77 grams, 5.28 grams, and 5.00 grams. So all of these were pretty close to the actual value, but they weren't close to each other, right? The range went all the way from 4.77 to 5.28. Not super precise, just generally in the ballpark of being accurate. Again, if this is what your scale is giving you, maybe it's just kind of a really cheap scale, like it's kind of knows what's up, but it also gets things like not close to each other. So far, I would not want to use any of these three scales in lab. I'd throw them all away and then steal a good scale from someone who had one. All right, so now let's do the only scale we want to use. It's going to be highly accurate and highly precise. So let's say our four values are something like this. 5.01 grams, 4.99 grams, 5.00 grams, and 5.00 grams. So this is great, right? This is what you want to do if you measure something four times. You get the same thing almost every time, and it should be the actual mass of what you're measuring. And so this is both highly accurate and highly precise. All right. Hope this video helped you understand the difference between accuracy and precision. I would keep on going back to the dartboard and really staring at those guys if they kind of don't make sense to you. And I like to think about the dartboards if I ever kind of am having trouble knowing if something is accurate or precise. And happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks, that's it. Happy studying.